Emma, and I'm here with another video. As you can see from the environment, actually at the Kumasi Fault, and then we are here to explore. So without much ado, just follow me right and let's explore.
So this place is called Kumasi Fort, and it is the only military museum we have in Ghana here. So the fort that you see here, it was constructed by the British in the year 1887. But before the British came and constructed this fort, there was an original structure here. And that structure was the palace for the Asante kings. So Asante kings and queens were living in the palace here. And that palace was built by an Asante king called Asantehene Osei Kwame Esibibunsu. He started the construction of the palace in the year 1807 and completed in 1820. It took him 13 years to complete the construction. And the palace was similar to the Cape Coast Castle. So four Asante kings lived in the palace here. The last king to live in the palace was called Nakofika-Kari. But in the year 1874, there was a war between the Asantes and the British, which we are being taught in our schools as the Seg and Etwosini War, or the Sagranti War. So the British invaded Kumasi, it was an invasion. When they came, they burned down the city of Kumasi. That time Kumasi wasn't big as we see it, and the building here was cottages, so it was easy for them to destroy it. And the palace here too, they mined the palace down. So the Asantes lost the war. So Sagranti forced the Asante elders, let me say the king, to sign a peace treaty with them. And that treaty was known as the Treaty of Fomina. And this treaty was entailing a lot of stars. But I would say these two things. First, they told the Asantes that the Asantes should pay them some amount of money. That is 50,000 oz of gold to the British as the war cost. And secondly, they also told the Asantes that the Asantes cannot go to the Gold Coast area, let me say Accra, Cape Coast, or the coastal area to trade with the tribes over there. So Asantes said, okay, they fed it. So yes, some years later, in 1886, there was an Asante king called Prempeh I. Prempeh I didn't obey what was in the treaty. Prempeh refused to be paying the money to the British. That is the 50,000 money supposed. So the British arrested Anna Prempeh. His mother, who was called Anaya Echan, and some elders and some chiefs and kings and servants of the royal family or the Asante kingdom. They arrested all of them. They took them from Kumasi to Mina Castle, then to Sierra Leone. So the king was exiled in Sierra Leone for over 20 years, but he returned back in the year 1924. So the reconstruction took place from the old Asante Palace Nombubun. So the British reconstructed this place mainly as a temporary residence for their military, and also residence for their officials, chief commissioners or governors when they are in Kumasi. So in the year 1900, still Asante had no king because the king has been exiled. So the British select some of the chiefs to act as king. So a governor came to Kumasi. The governor was called Governor Oxen. When he came, he demanded the surrender of the golden stool. And we all know that the golden stool is the soul of the Asante kingdom. The Asantes believe in the golden stool so much to the extent that they believe that the golden stool is taken away from them, there will be a disintegration among the states. So they will do whatever it takes to defend the golden stool. So when the governor told them that he won the golden stool, that led to the last breaking in Asante war, known as the Yasantua War or the War of Golden Stool. That was in 1900. So Yasantua was the commander-in-chief of the Asante army. She was the leader. So Yasantua and the Asante army, they trapped the British in this fort. The British were here. If we are British, you cannot go out. If you go out, the Asantes will kill you. But before these powerful weapons, they were killing many Asantes. They were killing 1,000 Asantes. If they killed 1,000 Asantes, so 1,000 were retaliating. Intinya Kasebi said, but finally, they were able to arrest the Asantua. When they arrested the Asantua, they took the Asantua to a condemned cell. I'll show you. There'll be an outlet in the chapter, baby room. And from that cell, I'm going to call Cape Coast Castle, then to Seychelles. So later on, the Asantes were defeated, and Asante became a British protectorate. So later on, this place became a training center for Gold Coast soldiers. So the British were training soldiers here to help them fight against their opponents in the world wars. So Ghanaians just fought in the First and the Second World War. So the First World War, that was 1914 to 1918, we fought against the Germans in Togo. And the Second World War, 1939 to 1945, we fought against the Italians and Japanese, both in Ethiopia and a country called Burma, respectively. So we have about 8 or 9, I think 10 exhibition rooms to go. You are free to ask any question. So we captured some weapons from the Italian, Japanese and Germans. So if you take a look here, this is called Italian mortar. This Italian mortar was captured from the Italians in the World War II. When you put a bomb inside and you shoot, it can go as far as 2,000 meters or 2 kilometers and it's very powerful.
It still works.
It still works. We also have where the buttons, that is what we're using, and the badges. Yes. And what we call Tiamofre. In English, we say rifle. So these rifles we also capture from the Italians as well. So the first one was captured from the Germans and the rest was captured from the Italians, and it was used by them in the World Wars. And now we used to be in the So there used to be a series of shooting competitions here. So in the year 1932, there was a shooting competition here and the soldier won this trophy. So they made a friend of them. Lance Corporal Alas Achel Pansy. Won a really beautiful trophy. Yes, I'm sure I think. We are telling to be a soldier for you, so it mostly goes with ammunition and weapons. We since here, pistol holster, you put it on your waist and you put the pistol inside. And then, Santa Shah, these are also bulletin cartridges. Artillery telescopic periscope.
Okay.
You can find it, sir. Second, this is a brand bayonet. Bayonet, no, tear about friend. What is Shan? Who been one? Now they are one. Future, no, it's
not.
No, it's when I did tear about friend. But it's a rifle, two women. Wait, there were the second, what is Shan? So we've done that somewhere to try. Now they are
one. Okay, so this man you see here is called Nana Jemfi. And he happens to be the owner for the hotel at Swami called Room Hotel. He had a special recipe of food that he used to give to the soldiers during the war. And then when they take it, it could be with them, like they could still remain full till like 3 days. And then they would supply them with another batch of that same kind of food for after 2 weeks, yes. So that's why his picture is
we Italian water bottle. I'm gonna crash in it and I'm gonna build. Yes, I'm just trying to say you can see some out from the crowd, and I say it's okay, so just from the crowd, you so from me. Kind of setting for pockets during the World War time, and that's a golden days. Now we in a couple of one communication sets. Phone back home, they can send you batteries in there. Easy,
you have to get to put it.
Connected to me. We mean a couple of batteries, batteries in there. Dial, we need the bonus. We have a switch for the soft. We have antenna for doing any money, network pool. Na that time, we are to see in a mom a boy shape. Over 94, from 93 Ghana. Equal to wear black Ghana in 1937. I said my friend Ghanaian and Kabuashi. It's always since you're a favorite gun by a friend of Schwartz losing middle machine gun.
Schwartz. One lady can't say if you're
a
It's
a past commander's
chief. It's a dinner on a very